Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the Grambling State University Sports Television Network. I'm Onaje Morris alongside Cleveland Jones, and we have us a game. We just had us a game, women's basketball team. Amazing game, a tough loss for Grambling State University to UAPB, but men's has the chance to redeem it. Men's basketball right now, Grambling State University men's basketball team is 8-11, 5-1 in the SWAC. That puts them at the tops of the SWAC right now. And as far as Arkansas Blind Buff, they're in the middle of everything right now. They're 8-11, 3-3 when it comes to SWAC. And when it comes to team stats, Grambling State University struggles a lot in offense, 11th in the offense, second to last. But when it comes to defense, no struggle at all, second in the SWAC. They're the defensively sound team, but they're going to have a matchup today. Cleveland Jones here to tell us about UAPB's.
Coming into this game, UAPB currently has the number one offense in the SWAC, with also on the flip side, the lowest ranked defense. At this point, they're averaging 82 points a game, but allowing 85 on the defensive side. Also, coming into this game on the offensive side, they are one of the best ball distributing teams with 16.2 assists per game.
Now, we're going to have a little bit more in-depth on the players. We're going to send it over to Riley McClain. She's going to give us a sideline report.
Good evening, everyone. This is Riley McClain reporting from the Willis Reed Gymnasium today. Tonight, the player to look out for will be Grambling State University Kentavious Dozier with a number of 14.3 points per game. From UAPB's team, the star player Kyle Milton is third in the SWAC with points 18.7 per game, and his teammate Rashad Williams with 17.7 points per game, contributing to that top offense for the SWAC. Back to you, OJ.
Thank you, Riley. When we come back, we'll have a starting lineup and a starting game for you guys right here on the great Grambling State University Sports Television Network.
Versus your Grambling State University Tigers.
Best tailgate, brisket.
No, real football y pollo asado.
Hoops and wings. Dude, subs.
Hot dogs.
Chili dog.
No, Dodger dog.
It's gotta be crawfish.
Now you're talking. Burgers.
Seven-layer dip. Ribs.
No contest.
Hummus.
What?
You need a hot grill.
And an ice-cold Coke.
Of course.
Football and Coke. Come on.
It's got to be Coke.
Game day.
Race day.
Calls for Coke. You know it.
Grab yourself a Coke.
It's tailgate 101.
And now, let's meet the starting lineup for your Grambling State University Tigers. Yeah, standing 6-1. 195 pounds, Jimmy Trumbull, and Alabama, the number zero, Kentavious Dozier. Standing 6-5, 205 pounds, sophomore from Montgomery, Alabama, number four,
Hello and welcome back to the Grambling State University Sports Television Network. I'm Onaje Morris alongside Cleveland Jones as we have the starting lineup here, Kentavious Dozier. We're going to also have Mikael Stevenson in the game. Jalen Johnson is going to have a start. Antoine Burden is going to be starting. And last but not least, Jordan Smith, the savior of the playoffs. So far, you're going to have us a game. I mean, the atmosphere and the stage is set. I think the women's basketball team set the tempo off correctly as we are seeing things being, incredible. I mean, a half-court shot made. A whole bunch of stuff was happening in that women's basketball game that we could get into, but this men's basketball game is going to be a thriller. When you have two teams that are literally, you have one that's low in the bottoms of offense, which is Grambling, but top in defense, and you have the number one offensive team, which is Arkansas Blind Buff, and they're dead last in defense. We're going to see a tale of two different teams, one that works defensively and one that works offensively. So we're going to have to see which one is going to have the outpower of each other, because if Grambling defense is better than UAPB's offense, they're going to put them away quickly.
Yeah, this really seems like a tale of two sides of the same coin for us this game, seeing how Grambling is a strong defensive team with UAPB coming in with their strong offense, the best in the SWAC. We really get to see which truly wins the game, offense or defense tonight.
Offense and defense will be the tell, a tell tick for tack. The guy with the suit and the guy in the sweatpants. We're going to see who has the better edge today. Of course, on the floor, like we said, it's going to be Tremichael Mode and Jordan Smith, Burden, Dozier, and Aku as we are tipped off and underway here in Grambling State University. Men's started the first half. Grambling State University with it. On the floor for UAPB, you got Kylan Milton, their leading scorer, third in the SWAC. Also on the floor, you got Trayvon Ware, number zero. Shot up, no good by Jordan Smith. Michael Molden with the offensive rebound in the buckets. Hello, how you doing? That's how you start the game off. 2 points for Grambling State University. As UAPB working. Martin Jr. with the ball. Doesn't get the bucket in. Rebound by Dozier. Dozier taking it up. In front of him was Rare. Rare with the steal. Going fast. The other way is Milton as he tried to finesse the layup and could not get it to go in. As Burnett, corner three. No good.
We see him trying to pick up right where he left off last game.
As you see Coach Dante Jackson trying to get his group together. Get the posse together here. As Dozier was ready to put that bucket right back in. Taking it out will be Tremichael Molden. Aku with the screen, try to cut. Steal. On the floor, like I said, I didn't get through everybody on the floor for UAPB. You got Trayvon Ware, Kylan Milton, the third leading scorer in the SWAC overall. Nice moves by Ware, kicks it out. That's also Martin Jr. on the floor. Ishmael Pletz, number 45 for UAPB. And last but not least, Joe French is a name that might be familiar with you guys because he transferred from Bethune-Cookman to UAPB, was a lights-out shooter, and he is a lights-out shooter again. And as you can see, that's UAPB's coach. That is the youngest coach in D1 basketball history right now. He has just touched the age of 30. And he's the head coach for UAPB. Dozier, top of the key. Ware in front of him finds Burnett. Burnett slashes and stopped at a halt. Roll Dozier, shot, no good. Aku almost had possession of it, but it'll travel out of bounds. Pellet was in front of him.
In that moment, we see Aku doing what he does best, trying to pick up the boys and clean it up for our team like he usually does.
Most definitely, Jonathan Aku is a defensively sound player. He's gonna put a hand in your face and disrupt every pass possible as Joe French has it where to Milton. Milton finds Pletz. Martin Jr., deep three-pointer. Pure first points for UAPB is a tremendous one, deep three-pointer. And they're gonna take the lead off of that one. 1 point lead, 2-3. Here, UAPB has the upper hand. As Jordan Smith kicks out Tremichael Molden. Dozier finds Burnett. Burnett dropping a shoulder but loses the ball. Ware going the other way with it. Joe French stop and pop, doing what he does. Another three-pointer, two in a row for UAPB. And they jump out to a four-point lead.
Joe French, that's the kind of player we can't lose on offense. We got to find him in transition. Averaging 15.2 points for the season right now for UAPB. That's third leading scorer. We got to find him on every transition bucket.
I have an unwritten rule. If a guy wears number 30, you have to guard him behind the three-point line. As Shermichael Molden with the stop and pop mid-ranger to go. As Joe French with the drive kicks out Martin. Martin Jr. with another three. Three threes in a row for UAPB, and they are shooting at an outstanding clip right now. They are fearless from behind the line. And this is what this team does. They don't average 82.9 points per game for no reason. That's Shermichael Molden puts up another mid-ranger, but this one doesn't fall. That is going to be Milton going the other way. One of the travel called. Going to kick it out to Ware. Ware dribble drives, find Joe French. Thought about it. Martin is going to shoot it. First missed three. First missed three of the game for UAPB. Shot up by Molden, and it's going to be pure 2 points. And Shermichael Molden is carrying the load. His back is hurting. All 6 points is him.
And for him, this is not an new and unfamiliar position for him this season, being one of our stronger offensive players. This is an uncharacteristic start for the game for us as the Grambling Tigers, with our defense being a weak point for us right now. Usually you'll see us have a stronger contest and getting up on that.
After Plett, what a strong dunk. Defense is going to have to be key in this game. As like we said, Grambling State University is second in the SWAC when it comes to defense, and UAPB is number one. Dozier, hello.
3 ball of his own.
There we go. Somebody besides Shermichael Molden gets a bucket, and Dozier puts his name in and gets three. Joe French shoots his own, and Joe French. Oh, my goodness. UAPB is going to shoot this place into darkness.
It's looking like a shootout tonight.
Oh,
it might
man.
Be a shootout tonight.
Old Western film, six shooters, got him out, pointed.
See, he not wearing that 30 for no reason tonight.
What? It's like a Western movie in here. We got a shootout. Shermichael Molden with the travel. And UAPB is steamrolling with momentum. It's Coach Deontay Jackson has to take a timeout as UAPB has been smothering with the defense and three-pointers. We're going to take a break. We'll be right back here on the Grambling State University Sports Television Network.
Cultivate your career in broadcasting by attending the 2024 LAB College to Career Day Conference at Grambling State University on February 17, 2024. This professional development experience is an excellent opportunity for young broadcasters. Whether you want to be on or off the camera, we have a seat for you. To register and for more info, visit www.broadcasters.org. See you there.
But being able to create a legacy classic where you put them on a national stage.
Newark, New Jersey, it's the legacy classic.
It's gonna be a good one.
This is big right here. All we got is this one. All we got.
The transition. Grant Hill, how do you like that bucket?
Let's it fly from deep. Talking about stunting on national TV right here.
It's been great. We have a lot of amazing sponsors. It's a moment right now.
Legacy Stroll Up, Newark, New Jersey. And it's time to turn things all the way up right now.
At the buzzer!
Back here on the Grambling State University Sports Television Network, I'm Onaje Morse alongside Cleveland Jones. And getting back into this one, before we do, we're going to talk about what's next for Grambling State University. It's going to be the QQQ Legacy Bowl Classic, where they'll play against Jackson State University on TNT at 1 p.m. And then after that will be Hampton University playing against Howard University at 4 p.m. with a MEAC face-off. SWAC versus MEAC on TNT. How could you miss it? As Grambling State University has been struggling is drowning with the three-pointers that is being rained upon him. I mean, goodness gracious, Fork has 100% rain for UAPB, and they are letting it go.
Beating us from the three-point line alone this game right now. Joe French by himself almost killing us from the three-point line.
As we have a stop and play. Like I said, if a guy's wearing number 30, you got to watch him from the three-point line. And obviously tonight they are having no plans shooting it from the three-point line.
Man, not even three-point line. He's shooting it from about a foot behind. Shoots another one.
Oh, my goodness. That one was from Ruston, Louisiana. Couldn't get it to go.
A rare miss. And they're good misses, too. That's the worst part. Front of the rim, you got to watch that shot. You know the next one's going down.
Joe French has came into this game. I mean, scorching hot. Deontay Jackson looking to get his guys together. It's not a big deficit with all that has gone on, but goodness gracious, the way that they're shooting, you must show that to that second defense in the SWAC. You have to show that. You have to show that potential.
Yeah, we're seeing that number one offense at work in the SWAC right now. That's the worst part about those kind of transition threes. They can suck the air out of the gym. It's a five-point game, but it felt like we're down by 10 with the way we're reacting.
Yeah, because all the just off of the three alone, I mean, it's not even too much of the score. It's just how they're making it and what rate they're making it so early in the game. Jermichael Molden, and it bounces around all around the world, and it finds its way in the bucket anyways. Grambling State University tacks their name in for two, and they get it. Now go to the line for one more as he was fouled in the process. Replay here. You see.
Tough from the elbow pull-up with the lucky bounce. No, we see Moten taking on a more scorer's role, usually a more pass-first player for us, changing up his role and doing what we need, helping keep us in this game. Really all by himself, 8 out of the 11 points we have. And then coming through to stop the next best player on the other team. This might be Moten's game tonight.
Most definitely, as free throw couldn't drop for Grambling State University. Milton has it. Great defense by Jordan Smith to get into the passing lanes there. Said he wasn't allowed that one.
Now we're starting to see that second defense at work, starting to break up some passes and getting in those lanes, really helping getting our team ignited a little bit. Hopefully create some momentum for us on this next drive.
Most definitely, that momentum. They're going to try to turn defense into offense. Pletz with a nice move on Aku, but could not get the bucket to go. Aku is fortunate there. If that bucket would have went through, nightmares for him. Jermichael Molden out to the corner, and oh, my God. Great pass by Jermichael Molden, and Jordan Smith couldn't get a hold of it.
Got to be ready for those. In the corner.
Jeez.
Got the stop you needed. Got a lucky miss. Kicks into the corner. Just slips right out of his hand. Probably for the one more at the top. We've seen the man at the wing ready to shoot it.
Man, I mean, that was perfectly drawn up. Just couldn't get it to go down. Grambling here. Trailing by three. The magic number for UAPB, apparently, as they have been doing everything and knocking them down. Another three for UAPB. No good. Milton with the rebound, though. Milton pumps fakes, kicks it back out. Another three. Three no good. And you can hear everybody holding their breath as that three went up.
Man, every shot now, you see a lead in hands. The whole gym pauses for a minute. Watching UAP play, you see a lot of reminiscences of the old Rockets team with James Harden. Just a lot of running gun and really living and dying by that three-pointer. Here goes Joe French again with another one. Really starting to see that second-rate defense in the SWAC settle in. UAPB coming back down to earth a little bit, starting to put a couple misses together. Our defense starting to string some stops together. Now we just got to get the offense rolling.
Look, like they checked the temperature, it's the heat checking here.
Man.
As the three-pointers are starting to slow down a little bit for UAPB. Came out hot, starting to cool down just a little.
Yeah, 0 for 4 on their last few attempts, if I believe correct.
And Grambling State University is thanking the gods for that one as Jalen Johnson kicks out to Molden. Trying to give a three of himself. Aku
Aku and Kofor almost fought over the rebound there, but Aku would get the offensive rebound, kicks to Jalen Johnson. Jalen Johnson sets his feet, three-pointer, no good. Aku tries to bring it down, and it's going to bounce off of Bled Head, and it's going to go to where Rare finds Joe French. And Joe French, goodness gracious, you almost knew once it left the fingers, it was going to be a bucket. Same thing he was doing at Bethune-Cookman. He is just repeating it here at UAPB.
Man. Averaging 15 on the season, already got 9 with 11 to go in the first half. Looks like it could be one of those nights for the French.
Yeah, it could be one of those nights for him as Kofor pump fakes, takes it, and that's going to be a double hand block by Blitz. He was denying that like a bad card. We're going to have a timeout on both. Oh, Dante Jackson's going to take a timeout, his second timeout. They're going to go back. We're going to take a break ourselves. We're going to be right back here on Grambling State University Sports Television Network.
When you join the HBCU family, you become part of the tradition of breaking barriers in your community, breaking ground in your career, and bringing it with everything you do. From how you look to how you move in the classroom, on the court, and on the field. That's why Academy Sports and Outdoors is proud to celebrate the HBCU legacy and all those to add to it in their own way.
Louisiana National Bank is a proud community partner and loyal supporter of local education. LNB is excited to cheer on the Grambling State Tigers. Stop into Louisiana National Bank today to experience uncommon banking. To learn more, visit ln.bank.
Back here, Origin Bank, expanding your possibilities with flexible banking solutions. Whataburger, we build a better burger. Rocket Mortgage, the Louisiana Lottery Corporation. Rocket Mortgage, push the button, get mortgage, providing affordable mortgages and award-winning client services for more than 30 years. Nissan, proud sponsor of collegiate athletics. Louisiana Tourism, feed your soul. Coca-Cola, the official soft drink beverage of Grambling State University. Adidas, impossible is nothing. And we're back here as the troops are filling the court. Both coaches have said what they need to say. Coach Bozeman, third year for UAPB, like we said, youngest coach in D1 right now. Not just SWAC, HBCU, in all of college basketball. The man just turned 30 not too long ago, and he's been there for 3 years. He was a 20-year-old. He was 27 years old when they first hired him, making him the youngest coach in SWAC history as Jordan Smith puts up the mid-ranger, but it's no good. Going the other way with speed is Ware almost loses it. Corner three, Martin Jr., no good.
Seeing that board, that is one of the few bright spots we have had for the game so far. Our offense hasn't been consistently rolling, but Aku, who was subbed out for this recent break, was one of the consistent rebounders, keeping us in the game and competitive.
Most definitely, Jalen Johnson fighting for his life in the paint there. Ware comes in and fouls him. We have some new faces on the floor for Grambling State University. Mekhi Stevenson is going to be in. Mikael Stevenson, excuse me. And that's going to be Kofor, as you can see the replay here. Jalen Johnson tried to work in around Caleb Strokes, who just checked in to the game. Another new face for UAPB would be Rashad Williams. Rashad Williams, a very interesting player. He comes off the bench, but he's fourth in the SWAC with points per game, averaging 17.7. Even had himself a 26-point game where he was shooting 80%.
Man.
Crazy clip efficiency as one free throw drops for Grambling State University.
We saw a little bit against, Saw a little bit of that against last game for UAPB against Southern for Williams, where he dropped in 15 against them. It is interesting to see one of the leading scorers for a team coming off the bench, but you do see it a little bit in the NBA with a player like Malik Monk with the Sacramento Kings.
Most definitely. That's a beautiful comparison, especially as Williams put up a shot and it was no good. Jalen Johnson working, and he gets the ball stripped away by Stokes. Martin Jr. trying to get it. Almost a travel, and Joe French. Wow. Joe French knocks down the three-pointer, and they did not call a carry there. Everybody's shaking their head on that one as he was losing the ball, still out in his possession. It took, I mean, he could have took a suitcase with him, how many steps it took. As Michael Molden has it. Grambling State University is going to have a short memory with that one. Put it behind him. Burnett drops the shoulder, puts the bucket up. No good. Jalen Johnson snags it away. Jalen Johnson tries to put the bucket up. Doesn't get a foul and doesn't get the bucket. And Rare is going to have a fortunate mistake for Grambling State University and lose the ball. They'll travel out of bounds. And we have Michael Molden checking out and Zahad Mumford checking in with the bright and beautiful pink shoes. A lot of color on the feet today.
No, 100%. A lot of variety out here. You see, we got the AE1s, Anthony Edwards ones out there on the court, too. But with Mumford coming in, we can see Coach trying to take a more defensive-minded approach of bringing him in. Trying to get somebody in that can really stop French, throw him off his game, run him off that line a little bit. It's a sub I can really support and get behind.
Most definitely seeing Zahad Mumford come in with straight perimeter defense as Jordan Smith tries to work in the post but doesn't get it to go. As you can see, crowd almost cleared out there. Seeing them crashing in.
It's interesting to see our offensive game plan. You can see us as the physically bigger and more imposing team on the court. Constantly we hit the pick and roll and trying to hit the backdoor cuts for the easy two, but they've done good filling up that box and making it hard for us to finish over the top, which is allowing for the easy transition threes. You see Joe French get a lot.
Most definitely, and that's in transition threes and really pushing the tempo of what was the problem last game, Mississippi Valley State, which was pretty close as UAPB can't find nothing but Pletz. Stayed in the paint, and man, he throws one down.
Think the rim still might be shaking. No, it still is shaking.
The rim is still wobbly back and forth after his rim hanger. Stevenson drops shoulder. Jordan Smith finds Burnett. Burnett with the deep three. He's going to kiss the back of the rim and fall back. Milton thought about it. No good.
You can really see Graham trying to find that second story outside of Moulton that was really leading our offense and giving our charge, but I think 8 of our first 11.
Joe French left, but a lot of real estate in front of him, didn't get the three, but the offensive rebound, and Williams comes right back, and I mean, oh my goodness. The three-pointers are raining in, and UAPB is off to a commanding 13-point lead with 8 minutes left in his first half. We'll go to break. We'll be right back here on the Grambling State University Sports Television Network.
You want to be like the greats? First, believe you are. Greatness requires drip, not like that, like this. The greats aren't afraid to fail. They're fueled by it. Trophies require greatness, but greatness doesn't require trophies, because greatness isn't about what you've done, it's about what you do next.
From now on, it's all about us. Starting a family, buying a car, our first home.
They told you to open an account, then turned you away. They said, come back when you're ready. You said, we're ready now.
I know we're going to make it.
Hope makes it happen. Thousands of your neighbors, many who never had a bank account before, improved their lives with Hope Credit Union. You can too. Brighter futures begin with Hope.
Finally, another wide receiver in the house, my man.
So, you ready to learn how the Heisman's do it?
Can't wait.
once at 8, then again at 6.
Hi. Did one of you gentlemen use Nissan at home to order 40 Pathfinders?
Baker said it's another Heisman thing.
I didn't think you'd believe me.
Here are your keys, sir.
Back here on the Grambling State University Sports Television Network, I'm Onaje Morris alongside Cleveland Jones. And as you can see here, with all the replays, I mean, the threes have been coming in and they have been pure all night long for UAPB, barely missing any. They have been going crazy. Joe French leading the team right now with 12 points, all from the three-point line. I mean, literally been the name of the game, and Pat, it is really, really getting under the skin of Grambling State University. It's being a little bit too much for them to handle, but they have nothing but time, space, and opportunity to get back into this one. Grambling State University is not always known to be a first half team, especially this men's basketball team. They come out roaring in the second half. As you can see, the Golden Lions season stats, they're 8-11, 4-4 in the SWAC. Actually, they are 3-3 in the SWAC. As we have a reset of the clock.
It's interesting. Seeing Grambling in this position, you have to still have that good faith in us, knowing we didn't get the second-rate defense and not being able to come back from a game like this.
Well, also got to look back into last game, Mississippi Valley State. We trailed in back and forth in and out of that game that first half. And that was a very low-scoring game for Grambling State versus Mississippi Valley State, which occurred Saturday. Scores 54-46, and Grambling State University only really pulled away in the last 3 minutes of that game. So it was a lot of back and forth, and we were seeing a lot of issues, a lot of troubles they were having in the first half. But the difference between Mississippi Valley State and UAPB, UAPB are knocking those threes down.
Yeah, Mississippi Valley definitely did not have a Joe French on that team.
No, not at all. Nobody even near Joe French. They had a Jacob Paris.
No disrespect to Jacob, but Jacob not hitting the bottom of the net like Joe is out here.
I'm just saying, it's the opposite.
His levels out here.
You know, Jacob Paris.
It's definitely levels.
As the shot up, no good, but it'll be a foul. Send him to the free throw line for two. Jonathan Aku with the foul. And Grambling State University just has to keep UAPB ahead of them, or they will run away with it.
It's good seeing Coach go back to the starters, going back to that group that was our most productive offensive producing group, especially with Aku down in the middle. It should be able to ease up some of those dip down passes. We've seen those easy dunks, which should allow our guards to be able to guard the perimeter more.
Especially getting Dozier out there, they're a leading scorer as that free throw will drop their Milton. This game is a one for Grambling State University to get back into, 14-point deficit.
This is a good game for Grambling to show us truly who they are.
They're gonna have a stop and play. There's going to be a call on Milton. Getting a little bit too frisky there.
Starting to see Milton get anxious out there, seeing Joe scoring all the points.
Jordan Smith. Jordan Smith travels right out of bounds. Actually jumps out of it, looking for the call. Doesn't get it. Martin Jr.
It's impressive to think, to be the home team, to see how many calls are not going our way, not just not even looking at them, it looks like, for real, from the refs. You'd have thought this was an away game for Graham.
The air is being sucked out of here as UAPB trying to come out of here 2-0. Women's basketball already pulled off the win. They're trying to get their own Williams to Martin Jr.
We see UAPB really trying to bounce back from the loss they took against Southern last game.
Martin Jr. between the legs, bounce pass, but oh my goodness. Give that man a map. He lost Milton. And that ball is going to travel out of bounds, giving Grambling State University possession. Dozier takes it out. Moden takes it up. directing traffic, and they're just trying to breathe some life back into this offense. Oh, my goodness. Nice move. Tremichael Moden, three-pointer, could not knock it down as our DB sports table is a literal magnet for the ball. This is, I think, four games in a row, man, that we almost had everything taken off of it.
I know we grim, fam, but the ball can't find us like that.
Rozier, Dozier to Moden. Smith with the give and go. Dozier being fouled by Martin Jr. as he tries to lower himself, and he lowered himself a little bit too low there.
And we see the rare Grambling-friendly whistle as we see Dozier try to make that baseline drive from the wing. Just a little bit too slippery on that side of the court. Gets the foul call. Now we get to go to the line and see him knock down two.
Whatever it takes to stop UAPB from knocking down threes, as Dozier couldn't get the free throw to drop.
It just seems like we can't find the bottom of the net right now.
It is a vacuum seal on the bucket for us right about now.
Man, from free throws to layups.
Milton, pump fakes, kicks out. Joe French wide open. Three-yard pointer, no good as it touched the top of the backboard, meaning it is out of bounds. Grambling State University with a fresh 30 and the ball.
Even touching the top of the backboard, I know you had to see. Aku was the one who brought it down. Even without the out of bounds, that was coming this way with Grambling ball.
As we'll see Jordan Smith come out. And we'll have, that'll be Quinn Morrell coming in for him.
This is another one of our energy guys come in, help bring the team some momentum, spark some.
He reminds me, the way he shoots and plays, he reminds me of a Cam Johnson. He also looks like him as well.
Oh, 100%.
Michael Moden to Dozier with a nice pump fake. Dozier with a nice shot, but just couldn't get it to go in. I mean, oh, Grambling State University can't even purchase a bucket. They can't buy a bucket for 50 bucks right about now.
Man, that friendly bounce has been so unfriendly today.
Man, they are hitting everything around the bucket except the net or the inside.
Yeah, we didn't touch the net a couple times.
Yeah, for the last 5 minutes at least, Dozier been trying to get a bucket, but Grambling State University has been scoreless as we're going to have a traveling on Tremichael Moden, and I mean, in a literal sense, nothing, absolutely nothing is going in the way of Grambling State University. The trajectory is heading south.
On the bright side, during this stretch, we have seen the defense start to find a string some stops together. We just haven't let it translate to the offensive side. Take that momentum from getting that stop and bringing it over.
Milton with the finesse, and it's going to be a foul on Quinn Morrell as he's holding his mouth as he took a shot. He's going to get up and shake it off.
Man, that's our scrappy player doing what he does best, getting the game immediately, try to take the charge. Sometimes you take a little bit more with it. We can see he's trying to shake back from that receipt he took from that.
They're raining threes. UAPB has been raining threes. And when it rains, it pours, and that is the definition for Grambling State University right now. It is pouring on as UAPB tacks on one more with the opportunity of another. See on the replay, they have been looking for a call all night as Quinton Morrell tries to set his feet. It looks like that elbow clipped him in the mouth. He's going to be tasting some of his own DNA going for that one.
It's funny you mentioned pouring. We know what happens when it rains in Louisiana. It usually floods. Right now, we are in a flood.
Burnett to Dozier. Dozier to Moden. Back to Moden. Just trying to get anything going right now. We got a set by Jalen Johnson. Fives Moden. Moden kicks out to Morrell. Morrell on the wing, and that is going to be out of bounds on Quinton Morrell, and I mean.
Looking at UAPB defense, looks like they're running a 2-3 kind of man-ish cover.
Something
right
like
now,
how same. They are taking, looks like exactly what Mississippi Valley State were doing against us. And weirdly enough, Mississippi Valley State is Grambling State University with the steal. Dozier on the other. Oh! Head tops for everybody as the poster riser. Oh my goodness. That was a poster. He puts it all over his head. Joe Fritz trying to get it back. There is life back in here. And oh my God, that was so crazy. The security guards had to stand up and make sure things didn't get too crazy in here as he put it on his top. Goodness, man. God. And the three-pointer by Williams goes through as he is talking his mess now.
It's weird. I've never really seen a dead body talk like that before.
Man. He caught a body on him. He tried to get one back. As Dozier has another one. And the crowd now is amped up, too.
See Graham back inside of it and involved in the game again.
And one bucket. Grambling.
Go get three the hard way.
Trying to get back into this one. Another 2 points tacked on with the opportunity of one more. Grambling State University. They might be a little bit behind, but they have all but opportunity to get back into this one. We'll be right back here on the Grambling State University Sports Television Network.
Another wide receiver in the house, my man.
So, you ready to learn how the Heisman's do it?
Can't wait. Once at 8, then again at 6.
Hi, did one of you gentlemen use Nissan at Home to order 40 Pathfinders?
Baker said it's another Heisman thing.
I didn't think you'd believe me.
Here are your keys, sir.
Doritos created Solid Black in 2021 to help fuel the initiatives of Black leaders seeking to drive real change. Like Alvin Irby, and his vision to spread literacy, literally. Or Marvin Pierre, who's empowering our youth with skills that bridge the opportunity gap. Or Jessica Johnson, whose dedication to dreams helps make college a reality. And many more. Check out their stories and help shape change. We are Solid Black. Join us and try another angle.
HBCUs are anchored by legacy. They nurture the talent and determination of their students and prepare them for a bright future. The Home Depot's Retool Your School program has and still believes in the excellence of HBCUs, committed not just in speech, but through the revitalization and upgrades of the campuses these students call home. Building, planting, tilling the dream, all hearts and countless volunteers on the ground. Retool Your School. We're powered by purpose.
I'm Onaje Morris alongside Cleveland Jones, and we have the standings for you right now. Alabama State and Grambling State University is tied for first place, 5-1 in the SWAC. Falling up under them is a three-way tie. Southern, Bethune-Cookman, and Jackson State all set at 4-2. Texas Southern is 4-3. After today, we'll see what happens to this because games are still going on as we speak. Arkansas Pine Bluff is 3-3. And lower to the, and they're tied up with Alcorn State. Prairie View is 2-4, and later down the line trickles down as free throw is no good by Burnett.
Whew. Man, after that dunk, feels like we're in a new gym, new stadium.
Yeah.
Grand Slam is rejuvenated a little bit.
Dozier finds Burnett. Stevenson. Oh, he thought about it. He's gonna take it in. The take is no good. And now be a foul on Stevenson as well. A lot of whistles being blown here tonight.
Man, starting to see a few more go Graham fans' way, which is what we always love to see. Just now we get to the line, we got to convert though. Easy 3-point play for us right there. Left a free one at the line.
It's going to be a foul actually on UAPB. I saw Joe French, and I kept thinking Bethune-Cookman. He used to be, I mean, he was the guy for them last year. And now starting to look like the guy for UAPB here tonight. Stevenson, first free throw is no good. The crowd had even did to him the pleasure of being quiet.
Man. Starting to wonder seeing how French shooting out here. Wonder if he got the, all the little power.
Both free throws just not falling. You can hear the awes in the crowd as they really wanted that one back. 3 minutes, 23 seconds left in this first half. As Milton working on Jalen Johnson. Milton kicks out Martin Jr. Hand in his face. Three-pointer no good. Hofer fights for the rebound, but Blett almost came away with it. Jalen to Burnett. Kofer thought about it. Back. Had a three-point opportunity. Didn't take it. Burnett back to Dozier. Dozier with the three-pointer. Oh. And the rim is not being friendly to Grambling State University as it's rimmed out most of the time of the misses for Grambling State University.
Starting to see Dozier take back over as our lead scorer on the season. Really starting to see him look for his shot and really starting to get back into stride, especially after that energetic dunk we've seen. Really more of a posterizer. Good to see Dozier starting to find his flow again. Even in the miss, it's a good miss that we can see is going to encourage him to keep shooting out here. On the foul on the defensive end for Grambling State University, we have Williams taking it out under the basket for UAPB.
As they check it out, three-pointer right away from Joe French. Oh, my goodness. Perfect draw up there. As it was like a wall of screens in front of him, he takes a step back and he shoots another three. 15 points purely off of three-pointers. Go for one of his own, and it hits nothing but wind.
And French shot that three by himself. Nobody in the same area code as him. Got to get a hand up on the guy hitting nothing but the net, too.
Nobody even in his office place. Okay. As Blitz, oh my God, bulldozed his way to the bucket. And puts down an explosive dunk, and you can see them pulling themselves away. And UAPB has their opportunity to have a 20-point lead here.
We can really start to see the frustration coming out on the court from Grambling State University.
Oh, yes. Absolutely. I mean, frustrations are going to start running high here. As, like I say, UAPB has the opportunity here to make this a 20-point deficit for Grambling State University. Not looking good here. The win is being knocked out of Grambling. And the fan base that has came to support. They're trying their very best.
Yeah, we hear Grand Fan behind us doing their best to get involved in this game.
They get in their heads as the free throw drops, and that's a 20-point lead for UAPB. 2 minutes left in this first half, and UAPB is giving them everything they can handle.
Man, and we really see a lot of this team carrying over from their previous game. We see the big fella, number 45, in the paint. Last game, he had 14 rebounds. Just seeing him get 2-3 dunks on this side. Really starting to command that block and make it his own.
As Stevenson gets the mid-range bucket to go. To cut into that 20-point deficit that they're in. 1 minute, 30 seconds left in this second half. Williams, deep three. Williams. Martin trying to save it. Last touch by Jordan Smith.
See the heat check from Williams from almost the G on the court.
Man, that was the three-pointer that made, man, Grambling State University will have a lot to talk about at halftime. Regardless, they're going to have a lot to talk about at halftime. Before we go to halftime, we're going to send it over to Riley McCain, which is going to have a report, get a question from Coach, so let him go to get his troops together. As Ware finds Martin Jr. no good. Stevenson brings the rebound down, going the other way. Dozier, Williams in front of him.
The rare miss from UAPB from the three-point line.
Dozier bounce pass to Stevenson, kicks out. He tries to fight Jordan Smith. Martin Jr. intercepts that one. Block by Jordan Smith. Chase down. He's not LeBron. Stevenson taking it. Jordan Smith tries to take it up, and he's going to be fouled in the process. And coach for UAPB Bozeman is not happy about that foul. Almost checked into the game himself. Frustration.
Man, basically at the wing of the court. Would have counted for a sixth player.
As Plett probably looked at coach, was like, dang, I didn't even look at the player. My back was turned.
Yeah, that's one of those unfortunate game fouls. You just kind of get wrapped up in the flow of the game.
Just get wrapped up in everything.
Trying to box out, make a stop. Player coming at you full speed. Just get tangled up. Hopefully we'll see if George Smith can convert the 2 points for us this game.
Free throw up by Jordan Smith is good.
Definitely have to know that's going to be a point of emphasis when we get to when they get to the locker room. Converting on the free ones. Leaving too much money on the board from the free throw line this game so far.
Can't leave too many opportunities open as Jordan Smith gets both of them in. As we're slowly but surely getting to halftime. 30 seconds left. UAPB would probably like to dribble this one out as much as they can. Wouldn't have enough time to. Shot clock wouldn't allow. Jordan Smith having a conversation with the ref while playing defense. Plett has the top of the key. Finds Joe French. Got to stay on him. Good switch by Jonathan Aku. Jonathan Aku had an opportunity to block that, but he's going to get the rebound instead. As Joe French can get the layup. As time running low. Jordan Smith, dribble drive, and it's going to get the buzzer beater. Two buzzer beaters in a row at halftime for men's and women's. And your halftime score is 37-23. And we're going to send it over to Riley McClain as she's going to get the head coach for an interview.
Go. Hello, everyone. I'm Riley McClain, and I have Coach Jackson here. Coach Jackson, what do you plan to tell your team in order to take that W in the second half?
We got to come play with some energy and effort. They are shooting the ball at a high level, and we got to get out there and contest shots. Got to rebound the ball. We just not playing the way we need to play.
Understood. Thank you so much, Coach Jackson. Back to you, OJ.
And we will be back after halftime. We'll be right back here on the Grambling State University Sports Television Network.
HBCUs are anchored by legacy. They nurture the talent and determination of their students and prepare them for a bright future. The Home Depot's Retool Your School program has and still believes in the excellence of HBCUs, committed not just in speech, but through the revitalization and upgrades of the campuses these students call home. Building, planting, tilling the dream, all hearts and countless volunteers on the ground. Retool Your School. We're powered by purpose.
This is it. Our last night sharing a room. Tomorrow, we'll be in our new home.
They told you buying a home would take years, but didn't help you start. Still, you kept trying.
You'll have a yard to play in, a place to dream.
Hope makes it happen. With tailored mortgage solutions, Hope Credit Union makes home ownership happen for thousands of people, regardless of income or credit. Brighter futures begin with Hope.
Cultivate your career in broadcasting by attending the 2024 LAB College to Career Day Conference at Grambling State University on February 17, 2024. This professional development experience is an excellent opportunity for young broadcasters. Whether you want to be on or off the camera, we have a seat for you. To register and for more info, visit www.broadcasters.org. See you there.
This is it, our last night sharing a room. Tomorrow, we'll be in our new home.
They told you buying a home would take years, but didn't help you start. Still, you kept trying.
You'll have a yard to play in, a place to dream.
Hope makes it happen. With tailored mortgage solutions, Hope Credit Union makes home ownership happen for thousands of people, regardless of income or credit. Brighter futures begin with Hope.
Building champions for life didn't just happen overnight.
Since 1920, the Southwestern Athletic Conference, SWAC, has been in the forefront in leadership and excellence in all our athletic programs. There are very few major sports halls of fame that a SWAC athlete is not a member. Hall of Fame coaches who were stewards and mentors to these elite athletes, our tradition, our distinction, our legacy. We are the SWAC, building champions for life.
Join the HBCU family. You become part of the tradition of breaking barriers in your community, breaking ground in your career, and bringing it with everything you do. From how you look to how you move in the classroom, on the court, and on the field. That's why Academy Sports and Outdoors is proud to celebrate the HBCU legacy and all those to add to it in their own way.
Being able to create a legacy classic where you put them on a national stage.
Newark, New Jersey, it's the legacy classic.
It's gonna be a good one.
This is big right here. All we got up to the all we
got. In transition. Grant Hill, how do you like that bucket?
Let's it fly from deep. Talking about stunting on national TV right here.
It's been great. We have a lot of amazing sponsors. It's a moment right now.
Newark, New Jersey. And it's time to turn things all the way up right now.
At the buzzer!
Broadcasting by attending the 2024 LAB College to Career Day Conference at Grambling State University on February 17, 2024. This professional development experience is an excellent opportunity for young broadcasters. Whether you want to be on or off the camera, we have a seat for you. To register and for more info, visit www.broadcasters.org. See you there.
Where could reinvention take your business? Accenture, let there be change.
What are you guys doing?
Learning that HBCUs are not only about networking. There's also secret handshakes.
That's cap. HBCUs do not have secret handshakes, right?
You mean this secret handshake?
Cool. Wow, these guys are almost Cricket 5G fast.
We're kidding. There's no such thing as a secret handshake.
Or is there?
Whoa! That's how you do it! Wow.
Huge play coming up.
Oh, wait, I can pass.
Talking about dropping the ball.
I got the score.
Tostitos Hardy Dippers.
We'll be right back.
But being able to create a legacy classic where you put them on a national stage.
Newark, New Jersey, it's the legacy classic.
It's gonna be a good one.
This is big right here.
All we got up is all we got.
The transition. Grant Hill, how do you like that bucket?
Let's it fly from deep. Talking about stunting on national TV right here.
It's been great. We have a lot of amazing sponsors. It's a moment right now.
Legacy Stroll Up, Newark, New Jersey. And it's time to turn things all the way up right now.
At the buzzer!
As usual, but he just met Whataburger's Southern Bacon Double with crispy bacon, crunchy slaw, and a tangy sauce. Good call, Coach. The limited time Southern Bacon Double from Whataburger. Just like you like it.
Best tailgate, brisket.
No, real football, y pollo asado.
Hoops and wings, dude. Subs.
Hot dogs.
Chili dog.
No, Dodger dog.
It's gotta be crawfish.
Now you're talking.
Burgers.
Seven-layer dip.
Ribs.
No contest.
Hummus.
What?
You need a hot grill.
And an ice-cold Coke.
Of course.
Football and Coke, come on.
It's got to be Coke.
Game day.
Race day.
Calls for Coke. You know it.
Grab yourself a Coke.
It's tailgate 101.
This is it. Our last night sharing a room. Tomorrow, we'll be in our new home.
They told you buying a home would take years, but didn't help you start. Still, you kept trying.
You'll have a yard to play in, a place to dream.
Hope makes it happen. With tailored mortgage solutions, Hope Credit Union makes homeownership happen for thousands of people, regardless of income or credit. Brighter futures begin with Hope.
Where's everybody going? This game's not over. So we're not the best.
Our kicker stubbed his toe on the ball, and pretty sure our mascot has his costume on backwards.
But this is our team.
No matter what.
Guys doing? Learning that HBCUs are not only about networking. There's also secret handshakes.
That's cap. HBCUs do not have secret handshakes, right?
You mean this secret handshake?
Cool.
Wow. These guys are almost cricket 5G fast.
We're kidding. There's no such thing as a secret handshake.
Or is there?
Whoa. That's how you do it.
Building champions for life didn't just happen overnight. Since 1920, the Southwestern Athletic Conference, SWAC, has been in the forefront in leadership and excellence in all our athletic programs. There are very few major sports halls of fame that a SWAC athlete is not a member. Hall of Fame coaches who were stewards and mentors to these elite athletes Our tradition, our distinction, our legacy. We are the SWAC, building champions for life.
Right back here on the Gramercy University Sports Television Network. I'm Onaje Morris alongside Cleveland Jones. And halftime is concluding. And your score is 37. UAPB Grambling State University 20. And boy, oh boy, oh boy, has this been a game for UAPB. Especially 43% from the field goal to our 30. 42 from the free throw to our 12. 75% from the 3-point. To our 22. 5 turnovers to our 10. 17 offensive rebounds to our 18. 3 fouls to our 1. I mean, 75% from the 3-point line to 22% is the reason to tell you a tall, the longest tail of all. Why this score is like this. There's various ways why this score is like this. Mainly it's because of the 3-point shooting, but on the other end, it's not really that the fact that Grambling State University is really killing themselves. They are not, they have not been able to knock down shots at a rate that's been good enough for them to even stay remotely close in this game. They're going to have to get back into this game in order for them to get back into this game. First, they're going to have to give UAPB a taste of their own medicine. They're going to have to put some threes up. Yeah. They're going to have to not only put some threes up, if not a three, get shots that are high IQ shots. Shots that you know that's going to all going to be automatic. Yeah. Get Dozier more his touches. Get Jordan in his spots. Get everybody what they would usually do. Get them in their comfort zone. So automatically start knocking down shots and then slowly momentum will start to build. But in order for a comeback, you'll need great offense and great defense.
It's interesting to say that because watching the game, look at the numbers that you just read on. That rebounding number has to be a number I highlight. Seeing how we're dominating on the boards, you can see we're getting some of the stops that we want. Of course, we're hitting a lot of open threes and getting a lot of open shots. But for us on the offensive end, it's not so much not taking bad shots, not forcing it. We're just not converting. We're genuinely just missing shots that we hit last week against the Mississippi Valley. Yes, like you did mention earlier in the game, we did trail a little bit, had to make our comeback. As you see, taking a little bit from the Mississippi Valley defense. Hopefully we'll have that same comeback we had last week, get that same win that we got.
Honestly, Mississippi Valley State, when it comes to that, they weren't hitting threes like UAPB. When it comes, it looks like that big brother, little brother thing where the big brother do something so cool and does it so often. It makes it look so effortless. And Grambling right now is the little brother. It's like, oh, I'm trying to do that, but they can't. They feel pressure.
Because we're getting a lot. That's 100% true. It's a great comparison because we're getting a lot of the same shots. We're getting a lot of the same looks. It's just Joe French is doing that.
Oh, my God. To start off the second half, right where he left off, another three-pointer, 18 points purely, strictly off of the three-point ball. I mean, goodness gracious, as Burnett jacks one up of his own, no good. There has to be conversions in the midst of all that is raining down. Passes it to Blett to Milton. Milton, another three. Oh, my goodness. Nothing but net. Two threes in a row for UAPB to start this second half off to now regain a 20-point lead.
He's going to be that igniter. He's going to be that flame, but that's going to really help ignite Graham and really set us all. I thought it would be going with the dunk that we had at the end of the second, the first half. So.
The craziest thing about that is UAPB let that posterizer by Dozier be a fuel ignition for them.
Turned them up.
They turned them up. Immediately got crazy, yeah. But Williams immediately got a three after the dunk as Martin Jr. could not get the layup to go.
Like you said, here. They let little brother get that dunk off, came down and showed him big brother's three. Oscar with the miss, just point blank in front of the basket.
Oh, my goodness. And Dante's trying to get the platoon together, but it is hard to even purchase a bucket right now. Joe French lines it up, and oh, my goodness. by the grace of God, doesn't hit that three, but UAPB gets an offensive rebound, a putback, and a foul on Jonathan Aku. Now send them to the free throw line for two. And it seems like if UAPB doesn't get it the first time, they do the second. I mean, second chance points has been to a T for them. Grambling State University has to close down on these boards, get these threes up, really stop Joe French and these guys from shooting any more threes.
That 18 really sticks out completely by itself. And we're watching the way these shots are falling. This man, Joe French, is not hitting no one. He's going straight to the top of that deck and going straight to the bottom.
Free throw good. Milton, both will fall, making this a 22-point game. Grambling State University is trailing big.
I almost feel like we're watching the space. I feel like we lost all our power.
Oh, man. They got the magic ball, and they sucked all their powers away. Man. Crazy comparison, but absolutely true. As we're having troubles, I mean, tough times here. No reason to hold your head low, especially if you're Dante Jackson. That's something he'll never do. Inbound, Aku, Burnett to Molden. Molden takes three. Molden makes three. Three by three, brick by brick, as they're going to have to build a strong house. And there we go. Momentum, Tromaco Molden with the steal. Thought about it. Wide open player, but oh, he loses them. Every time you think momentum is going to kick up,
like I'm watching the Ravens last night.
Oh, boy. You know, that was a tough, you know, not to, to get far, get up too far off topic, but that was a tough game for me to watch because I hate the Chiefs and I really hate the Ravens too because I'm a Steelers fan. But here, we are.
You might have to clean this up a little bit.
Hey. As the putback, oh, my goodness. Collette had opportunity after opportunity. He gets the bucket in and was fouled. He'll go to the free throw line for the opportunity to one more and make this game back. 20-point deficit for Grambling State University, as you can see here on replay.
At the top of it, right with himself.
Three chances there.
Man, you got to make it a Sunday finish.
You got to. You have to. Like, three chances off of already him getting a rebound off a missed layup for French. Good enough. They have to fight back on the boards as this is now a 20-point game. I said he made the bucket. Excuse me, he did not. Go to free throw line for two. But second free throw, no good.
I guess they can.
Oh, most definitely. I mean, shoot, you for a second kind of forgot they could.
Man.
Tremichael Molden, he dribbles, he drives, he will take a foul, and he will walk his way to the free throw line as he will get two of them. Tremichael Molden.
Really carrying the offensive load tonight, leading the way with 11 points right now. 11 of our 26. Kind of frustrating. You can kind of see where we dropped off and see where the momentum started to shift a little bit. Seeing as he got his 11th point in the second half. Started off the game with a quick eight, if I'm doing correctly.
Yeah, literally quick. Right off the dribble. He had at one point all six of the points for Grambling State University at the very beginning of it.
Pass to the sub, the UAPB, bringing in Robert Lewis off the bench.
Two free throw drops for Tremichael Molden, giving him 13 points on the game so far. Bringing it within 18 for Grambling State University. Williams, their second leading scorer, working on Jonathan Aku. Tries to find Jonathan Joe French, but he finds the scorer's table instead.
That's one of the hard parts about this game. You really are seeing the defense doing what they do best, forcing tough passes, great tough shots for the team to hit steal. He just hasn't been converted. So Joe Prince's threes are killing us. Because as you see, they're not coming back to back to back. They're spread out.
Spread out, most definitely. It's almost so spread out, you almost forget about Joe Prince in a sense.
You forget it until he hits the bottom of that net.
Once again, as shot is no good by Grambling. Nice move by Molden. He slashes. Doesn't get the bucket, but another whistle blown. You would think the Alphas were stepping in here. How many whistles we've been hearing? We're going to have another two at the line, as you can see. Milton losing Burnett, getting on his weak side and just drawing the foul from Jalen Johnson.
And seeing Burnett, uncharacteristically quiet game for him, coming off of the he had a double-double last game. Coming off of the double-double from last game against Mississippi Valley, bringing in 14 points and 12 rebounds. Now Trojan went in just three, hoping to see him and those who ignite that offense.
Jermichael Molden going the other way as Milton will now have 10 points after getting those two free throws. Drop 20-point lead now again. It seems like every time Grambling State University slips out of that 20-point deficit, UAPB stuffs and put them right back in their place. Goodness gracious. Flirting with it. They're in love with it. And they're going to take a break here. We're going to take a break as well. We'll be right back here on the Grambling State University Sports Television Network.
What is Grambling? Grambling is growing. It's a community. Grambling is an education. An experience. Grambling is legacy, tradition, and future. What is Grambling? Grambling is all of this and more. Grambling is the place where everybody is somebody.
Hey, Don, what made you become a Cricket Campus Ambassador?
Do tell.
I live to network. HBCU is all about that. The key word being network.
Oh, like a certain network that has speedy 5G and is a proud sponsor of HBCUs?
I see you could take a hint.
I can drop a hint too, Don.
Coach here always orders as usual, but he just met Whataburger's Southern Bacon Double with crispy bacon, crunchy slaw, and a tangy sauce. Good call, Coach. The limited time Southern Bacon Double from Whataburger. Just like you like it.
Where could reinvention take your business? Accenture. Let there be change.
Right back here at Grambling State University Sports Television Network. I'm Amaje Morris alongside Cleveland Jones. And we are seeing Grambling struggle. As most of we've seen them struggle all SWAC play. They struggled a little bit against Mississippi Valley State. And as you can see, 5-1 in the SWAC. They have not struggled much. But when it comes to offense, they have struggled a bit, being second to last. But when it comes to defense, they are second in the SWAC, and like that says, last season struggle to win was kind of a dud because they made it all the way to the SWAC championship, but they struggled to win in there. I think this season we are 5-1, but we're still struggling to win. Every game that we won has been tight in a sense. There's been one or two blowouts, but every game we've had has been tight, especially the last two that's been here at Grambling State University. One against Mississippi Valley State Saturday was as tight as it could be. And this one, not really tight, slipping away from Grambling State University. Have 15 minutes left to spare. Enough time to get back into this one, but they must be effective and immediate.
Yeah, we're going to get back into this one. Definitely got to start.
Bucket good. Jermichael Molden from three. as he lands another one from three-point land. 16 points on the night for Jermichael Molden, doing everything he can. Jermichael doing everything he can, single-handedly almost at this point. As Milton slashes, Malik Layman, oh my goodness. Malik Layman was all over him, still couldn't disrupt the stop as he'll fall. 19 lead, point lead for UAPB Golden Lions. Goodness gracious, the Lions are showing to be more powerful than a Tiger in this one. So Michael Moten kicks out, trying to get anything working. They have singled him out, knowing that he's scoring everything they got. As Burnett fighting for it on the ground, is gonna jump off, possession arrow goes to Grambling. So it will stay for Grambling.
When you were coming into this game, allowing 85.4 points a game, a swag word, really not the UAPB team we thought we would see tonight.
Most definitely. This is not what being dead last in defense is one thing, but coming out and looking like this is a whole nother thing in itself. Jordan Smith puts up the shot immediately. He will be fouled in the process, sent to the free throw line for two. Opportunity to cut a little bit into this lead that UAPB has. And when you have games like this, it is tough to try to not only make an adjustment, but get back into it. There's so much that's required from a team to wake up, and not only wake up, but to have the focus to string things together, string points together, string defensive drives together, string steals together, blocks, rebounds, whatever the case may be. It takes a physically, mentally, and emotionally strong team to do all three things, in a sense, to score, play defense, and stay in it.
Hey, and it starts right there with Jordan Smith knocking down those two free throws.
And that's the starter if we need any. I mean, anything could get us jump started here. That's Martin.
See if we have some guys still left in the tank. 14 and a half left. Only down by 17. Game far from over, but only Grambling Tigers can tell us that.
Most definitely, as you can see Grambling in his 2-3 zone they're playing in. Definitely working there against UAPB.
If you were Coach Jackson, looking at this game and seeing how it's going, what would be your offensive approach? Would you live and die by the three or try and get to the basket?
First and foremost, I would hate to be a coach in any situation. But in this situation, you are, oh goodness gracious, Milton from three-point land. How do you do? Knocks it down, 15 points for him. He extends it to a 20-point lead again. Has a three ball from Jordan Smith. He claps right back. But if I'm Dante Jackson, I am doing that exactly. I am gunning for threes and getting anything in between that I can get. But regardless, I am trying to get buckets every time I'm coming down on the offensive end of the board. Three-pointer, Jermichael, and it is good! As he knocks him down, another one, two in a row for Grambling State University. 19 points from Jermichael Molden. He has a sword, he has a shield, he's fighting by himself here as he scratches the ball and trying to get back into this one. We're gonna stay here. Oh, no. One thing I do not like is stress, especially stress of the job. As we see Jermichael Molden in the slash button there. Jermichael Molden has been on fire tonight. The score is unfortunate, especially for him, because he has done everything in his power so far. He's not even Grambling State University in this, but as far as on the other end, he have the team effort. No Prince, and you also see him, Milton, both in double digits. No Prince having 18 points, and Milton having 15. Put Jermichael Molden on UAPB. He will be their leading scorer. He's the leading scorer in this game, but you're all by yourself, especially on a team like UAPB, clicking in all cylinders. Every guy that's in right now also has points. You can't say the University. 18 points for Milton, 6 points for Williams, 23 points for Mark Jr., 18 points for Prince, and then 8 points for Flint. That's just as far as the starter. So. I'm most likely try to channel things through Jermichael Molden, but somebody here is going to have to step up big to help Jermichael Molden.
Step up with that big 40, bro. Starting to get to it, knock down the three with the 2-3 throw.
That's the best way you're going to cut into that lead as a three-pointer by UAPB. No good.
Molden's starting to go get the rebound himself, too, man.
Jermichael Molden! Three-pointer, no good. Quentin fighting for it. Quentin couldn't find it. Joe French has it. Possession arrow goes to UAPB, so they'll get the ball regardless if they took a timeout or not. High IQ play for Joe French trying to call a timeout, but no need for it as the possession arrow is already in their favor. Some faces on the floor right now is going to be Malik Lehman, Jordan Smith, Jermichael Molden, Quentin Morrell, and Zahad Mumford is on the floor for Grambling State University. Bounce pass by Ware, mentioning Ware, he's on the floor as well. Ware, Blett, Martin Jr., French, Milton is on the floor for UAPB. Definitely trying to get something going. I mean, looking up here at the fouls, I mean, one of them get his first, but looking over at UAPB, every player in right now has two or more fouls in this game. Don't know how much that will matter.
Gotta convert on that free throw. That's the worst part. The fouls will tell a different story, but just haven't been knocking them down.
Milton, wide open three. Pure as it goes down. And Milton has something to say to the crowd. I didn't like it. It felt like it was directed towards me.
Man, he looked directly at us right there.
He kind of looked just at me. And, yeah. Didn't like that one. Like I said something to him. As Jordan Smith, three-pointer, no good. Williams, rebound. As Grambling just seems like they're allowing the life to be sucked out of them right now.
Look, they can get to this time. They can got the average on the ball for 18. French coming in for 18 on his own.
French trying to go for 21 there. It's no good. Jermichael Molden gets it in, try to get the bucket, the tip in, but it's going to be foul on Jermichael Molden, sending him to the free throw line for two. Deucey.
A late whistle by the ref. It's almost like they waited to see if he missed it.
We have a stop on the floor, so we'll stop as well, take a little break. We'll be right back here. On Grambling State University Sports Television Network.
Hey, Don, what made you become a Cricket Campus Ambassador?
Do tell.
I live to network. HBCU's all about that. The keyword being network.
Oh, like a certain network that has speedy 5G and is a proud sponsor of HBCUs.
I see you could take a hint.
I can drop a hint too, Don.
The world famed Tiger Marching Band presents Click It or Ticket. Drive sober or get pulled over.
To your horses, because it's back. Unless you didn't know about it, in which case, it's here. The Jalapeno Cheddar Biscuit is back and here for a limited time at Whataburger. Just like you like it. Coach here always orders as usual, but he just met Whataburger's Southern Bacon Double with crispy bacon, crunchy slaw, and a tangy sauce. Good call, Coach. The limited time Southern Bacon Double from Whataburger. Just like you like it.
Back here on the Grambling State University Sports Television Network, I'm Najee Morris alongside Cleveland Jones. And looking at the numbers at this game, it's just tall tales of what's going on. 41% field goal to R33, 43% three-pointer to R22. And that percentage literally just dropped off of a few missed shots. Everything else looks pretty normal besides the free throw percentage, us 52, them 81. Grambling State University has not been able to get anything really truly going for them. Have not been able to get traction. Yeah, that is not a good free throw as a team as well. As a collective, that is not a good percentage. None of the percentage as far as shooting is something to brag about tonight. Jermichael, he's been amping it up, and you have to kind of feel for him. Doing a lot, doing everything he possibly can, putting up 20 points, his first 20-pointer of the season. Has not reached this many. This is his, not career, but season high. 20 points. Knock a few free throws down to bring this game within 15. 11 minutes left to go. Nothing. It's everything but over. Everything but open. Over. As Joe French is just sitting in the corner wide open. Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. Another three knocked down. I mean, he's off in the corner just waiting, sitting there. And he's going to get the wide open bucket.
Yeah, starting to see a little bit of grim.
Yeah. Starting to see him clear out. Starting to get hard to watch here. Most definitely. Jesus.
It's frustrating to see because we're down 16 with 10 and a half minutes left in the second half.
Yeah, the crowd has a lot to do with this. The crowd has a lot to do with this. It's the energy. If you're a player, you start to see the crowd leave. I mean, hey, it starts to you know, even dense more of your confidence, because this is not that far of a deficit, especially how UAPB's been shooting. Goodness gracious, it could be a lot worse than this.
And we're not shooting our best, but we are making shots and racing to the point where you never know what could spark and what could ignite in our team. It is frustrating to see them leave. Look at them. Rambling on the front, not their name in the back. So
yeah.
Kind of frustrating seeing who they represent and leave them out here.
Hey, it's been a tough one to watch, but it hasn't been impossible.
You got a couple of highlights throughout this game.
Oh, yeah. Dozier with that head tap. Oh, my God. That's what I say is the best play, if you ask me. Beyond everything else, the best play is Joe French. He's getting buckets. As now UAPB have two players with 20 points, Milton with 20, and Joe French with 21. As Jermichael Moden kicks back out.
It's almost like the other players aren't even out there when Jermichael touches him. Just being engulfed by the defense of that play.
Most definitely. They are, this UAPB defense has figured that they are definitely going to key in on Jermichael Moden, and that's what they have been doing. His teammates around him has been struggling. As Jermichael Moden has 21 points in the game so far, him and Joe French tied for the most in the game. As three-pointer by Milton, he's going to get his own rebound. As there's going to be another opportunity for UAPB. Looking for a spark here. Dribble drive by Martin. Shot up, no good. And they're going to get a putback. That's going to be the youngster, Robert Lewis, 6'9", sophomore.
6'9", 2'10".
Slender man, as the shot is not to go down. And it looks like desperate shots being taken here. 20-point deficit. They have to slow it down. The game is not out of reach, and it feels like it, but it's really not out of reach. 8 minutes, and it's a 20-point deficit. Still have more than enough time to get back into this one, but Joe French with the turnaround fadeaway shot now has 23 points in the game to extend it now to 22-point lead for them. We're going to have us a quick 30-second timeout. As Joe French actually has 23 points. Oof. I mean, there is a lot of room to change. There's a lot of room left. I mean, there's a lot left to be desired here. And the main thing is, Ramblin' just has to get their heads back into this one. And it's very real, it's very possible that they could probably come back. But with things being said, we can't ignite that fire for them. We can't set that spark for them. They have to. So
look at this group.
Definitely. I mean, as far as aspects of where they stand on offense and defense, this one is kind of turning out somewhat of what we did not expect. As it is getting down to the nitty gritty, Grambling State University has, I mean, they, I do think they have ample opportunity to make it, but it is up to them as Cofer. To Smith, Cofer, Smith, Stevenson, Dozier, and Mumford on the floor for Grambling for UAPB. Williams, Ware, also Lewis. As if we get a bucket, 2 points stacked on for Grambling State University. Jordan Smith.
Hopefully, we get a couple air ones off of those, but gotta convert the free throws. What you do?
On the floor for UAPB, like I was saying, Ware. Williams, Lewis, Milton, and French. French has not been out pretty much the majority of this game. They're going to make sure that he gets his numbers tonight, as he has already has 23. He has to jack the shot up. Oh, my goodness. Shot clock violation, and we're going to have another timeout by Keontae John Jackson. We'll be right back here on the Grambling State University Sports Television Network.
This is it. Our last night sharing a room. Tomorrow, we'll be in our new home.
They told you buying a home would take years, but didn't help you start. Still, you kept trying.
You'll have a yard to play in.
A place to dream.
Hope makes it happen. With tailored mortgage solutions, Hope Credit Union makes home ownership happen for thousands of people, regardless of income or credit. Brighter futures begin with Hope.
The Walking Tree is said to change its entire location in pursuit of sunlight. Where could reinvention take your business? Accenture, let there be change.
Join the HBCU family. You become part of the tradition of breaking barriers in your community, breaking ground in your career, and bringing it with everything you do. From how you look to how you move in the classroom, on the court, and on the field. That's why Academy Sports and Outdoors is proud to celebrate the HBCU legacy and all those to add to it in their own way.
Where could reinvention take your business? Accenture, let there be change.
Back here on the Grambling State University Sports Television Network, I'm Onaje Morris alongside Cleveland Jones, and we are 7 minutes and 30 seconds out from the ending of this game. But so far, it has been tough trials for Grambling State University, still trying to keep things going. Stevenson to Mumford, Jordan Smith in the paint working against Blitz, and he gets the bucket to go in, tacks in another two for Grambling State University.
Hopefully that beat doesn't ignite.
Get the ball rolling in a sense as Martin, top of the key, Blitz, Kofor on him. Kofor just checked into the game for Grambling State University as well. Stevenson as well. New faces on the floor for UAPB is Blett, who has the ball, and he kicks out to Joe French. Williams with the jab step finds Blett. Blett waits it out, and he's going to put the bucket in. Took a little bit of time, but every time we seem like we get out a 20-point deficit, they put us right back in. We're going to have another timeout by Coach Jackson as he's trying his very best to get everything going here. And this one has just been really self-sabotaged a lot of times. Really can't get a lot of shots going in, but you also have to, I say it's a 50-50 on both ends. You have to credit UAPB's defense to being a pesky. On top of that, it's making it harder for them. Even when they have looks they want to take, they're questioning it because not only confidence now being down by 20, but their defense is closing out as well. Them being dead last in defense is not making, man, not making this case here.
I now see him just allow 67 points with almost 67 minutes left in the game. Really only 60-40 seconds left. Seeing the impact and the frustration that UAPB has been able to cause for him that's finishing at the rim has been an interesting game. Four plays for him to watch. But.
As UAPB come down the court, goes around to Michael Moden with the three-point shot. No good. Kofor tries to go for it. Puts his body on the line there. It's going to be a foul.
Kind of plays we need right now, though. Kind of guys willing to show us. Maybe hopefully that kind of effort will ignite something on the bench. Encourage some of the guys to sit up straight. Keep trust guys. A lot worse happened in less time.
Yeah, most definitely. Truly have.
See, they're kind of looking. Get a foul, stop the clock. You know, you got to convert.
as it's been tough trailing. Dozier's gonna go to the free throw line for two. We have 6 minutes and 30 seconds still remaining in this game. We're looking at three double-digit scores for UAPB. 2-2, Jordan Smith puts his bid in for 13. And of course, Jermichael Moden has 21. Dozier with a surprising only 6 points so far in his game, trying to make it 7, and he does.
Turned into how he started to attack the basket a little bit more. Looking like he will join Jordan Smith and Jermichael Moden in the double-digit club. Hopefully he does enough to help ignite our offense and get it back rolling. Get it rolling for us throughout the game.
As it has gotten timeout after timeout after timeout. We're going to have another timeout here on the floor. We'll be right back here on the Grambling State University Sports Television Network.
National Bank is a proud community partner and loyal supporter of local education. LNB is excited to cheer on the Grambling State Tigers. Stop into Louisiana National Bank today to experience uncommon banking. To learn more, visit ln.bank.
What it looks to be built in. Throughout this game, that's been a consistent number we have been calling as one of the most consistent scorers in the game. Pat bringing in 20 of UACB's 67 points at the line right now. And the first free throw is good. Brings the score to 68-49. UACB.
Milton, free throw is good. Bring that lead right back to that number, that special number. It's been two lucky numbers for UAP in this game, 3 and 20. Jordan Smith puts two up of his own.
Seems like Ramsey's only like 18 at this moment. Nothing past it, right down to 18.
Going the other way. It's going to be UAPB getting two free throws here. 2 points that Grambling just got. They're going to be able to get free opportunities to get those 2 points back.
Was it a notice that we didn't get today? Is this supposed to be a 20-point game?
At this point, I think so, as they have been able to keep it at that rate. As the free throw drops, right back to it.
About
5 minutes and 55 seconds to go. Stevenson pull up three, no good. Jordan Smith with the offensive rebound, kicks it back out. Dozier almost lost it, didn't. Jermichael Moden making a move, spin, layup, shot, and it's going to go down. Jermichael Moden, oh man, doing everything he can. His back is hurting, trying to carry the load of this team.
Man, Ty for one of the leading scorers of the game for the game, Ivers, with Joe French. We see it, even on that offensive play with the Jermichael Bucket. see George Smith slipping on the outlet pass to Dozier on the wing and slipping out of bounds. It just looks like one of those games for Grambling, except for Michael. Number five seems like the only one that's on fire right now.
As you can see, they look like they really are trying to cover the spread. As they get the 2 points, they're going to send them to the free throw line again for two.
As soon as we score, they immediately right back to the free throw line.
Immediately right back to the free throw line. Williams getting both free throws to drop. Sound like a record, broken record, but 20-point lead for UAPB. Jermichael working, kicks out. Jordan Smith, three-pointer. No good. Other way, Milton. Martin Jr., Kofor in front of him. This team is trying to play it all the way to the end here.
Man, really starting to see them. It's funny because you can see UAPB pulling their foot off the gas a little bit, but not too much to give Graham enough hope to feel like it's going to be a comeback for him.
Oh, that's Martin.
He's always kept attacking.
Martin Jr. with a nice move, galloping to the layup. Goes here. Michael Bone Jazz says he kicks out, and that's going to be blocking foul by Williams. To the free throw line.
We like to hear Jermichael Williams. Jermichael getting another chance at point.
Jermichael Moten just doing what he can. I mean, Jermichael Moten have the opportunity here to make it 25 points. You're going to have your first 20-pointer of the season. Hey, why not make it 30?
Man. Trying to bring us back to that lucky number. Right now, we seem like we done lost a little bit of our identity right now. We're at a 22-point deficit.
First free throw up. It's
rare miss.
No good. Supposed to be two free throws there.
A little miscommunication between the refs, allowing Malik to sub in on the first free throw.
Joe French trying to plead his case here that it should be one free throw, but I believe it should be two as they're not going to get two free throws. They're going to get the ball back. As we now sitting and looking at, there is four double-digit scores for UAPB. Malik Lehman, oh, could not get the bucket to go in. Oh, and he's fighting to get it. Oh, and he gets the put back in for two.
Hey, we like a little step back right there, you know?
Malik Lehman able to get his own board. Put up two.
As you can hear, Graham's excited about Malik.
Joe French to Plett takes it. Oh, my God.
Plett flying up to the top board. When nobody else
can. What? He took an elevator up. He threw that one down. Shot up by Dozier. Shot is good. Here, oh my.
Dozier joined the double digit club.
Dozier is another one in this game that joined the double digit club. I mean, the club seems easy to get into. Martin. Oh, wow. No traveling on that as he took a couple too many steps.
Man, Martin got lost out here. Ended up in New Orleans with that travel.
Ref said he had a little sand in his eye. Milton kicks. Let. Oh, Malik Lehman made a business decision there as Let was obviously taken off for a hard landing. 3 minutes and 21 seconds left to give. And your game here will be right back here on the Grambling State University Sports Television Network.
Finally, another wide receiver in the house, my man.
So, you ready to learn how the Heisman's do it?
Can't wait. Once at 8, then again at 6.
Did one of you gentlemen use Nissan at home to order 40 Pathfinders?
Baker said it's another Heisman thing.
I didn't think you'd believe me.
Here are your keys, sir.
Being able to create a legacy classic where you put them on a national stage.
Newark, New Jersey, it's the legacy classic.
It's gonna be a good one.
This is big right here. All we got is this one. All we got.
The transition. Grand Hill, how do you like that bucket?
Let's it fly from deep. Talking about stunting on national TV right here.
It's been great. We have a lot of amazing sponsors. It's a moment right now.
Newark, New Jersey. And it's time to turn things all the way up right now.
At the buzzer!
University Sports Television Network, I'm Odaje Morris alongside Cleveland Jones as we're in the last final 3 minutes and 21 seconds of this one. As Plett will go to the free throw line for two. And this one has been nothing short of a difficult trip for Grambling State University as they're looking to put this one behind them. Next game coming up will be an exciting one for Grambling State University. They're on GSU TV right now, but next game they'll be on TNT for the QQQ Legacy Bowl Classic. They'll face off against Jackson State University, and our women's basketball team will actually face off against Jackson State University as well. But they will be going down to Jackson, Mississippi to face the Lady Tigers. Three-pointer by Tremichael Molden, no good. Kicks out by Jordan Smith, Dozier.
And speaking of Jackson State Tigers, they just completed a game against FAMU earlier where they just lost by 2 points. On the train right now, where Graham is going, both Jackson State and Graham will be coming into the Legacy Classic trying to bounce back to the ball.
Yeah, definitely don't want to go on a two-game losing streak in front of a lot of people on TNT, but that's going to be the stakes the way that this one's going. Grambling State University has every opportunity to come out and play Jackson State with a bang, and Dozier with the beautiful bounce pass. Crawford on the receiving end. Crawford with the dunk.
So he can do a little bit of everything. Our pick is score off for showing he got the court vision with the nice four-court bounce pass.
Oh, yeah. He's showing what he could do now. A little flash, a little something, a little pizzazz. As another foul, quick foul again. Free points. Never a good thing here. A lot of fouls, a lot of whistles being blown. A lot of things that Coach Dante Jackson is gonna wanna have to talk about. Never an easy one when you lose by a big deficit at home, but there's a lot to learn in a loss, always. There's a lot to learn in every game, but you learn more in a loss than any other game. Big losses, you even learn more about yourself, what kind of team you have. You learn about, all right, are these guys competitors? Are these guys going to come out next time and make sure nothing like this ever happens again? What kind of guys, what kind of squad do you have? This is going to test the chin and test the will of a lot of players as Dozier is fouled in the process. This is going to test the will and the mindset of a lot of players, especially not being able to come back in this one and get the win. It's going to test their will and seeing what's going to happen next week. And how they trickle down the line and play, and how they view this game coming forward.
And this is a great time to have a game like this coming in. Coming into the game on a 4-game win streak, middle of the season, not too deep, but still in an important part of the season. This is a good time to figure out, all right, these are some of the things we need to work on and really see what we need to change about our identity to make sure later on when it's SWAC tournament, this is not the outcome again.
Oh, yeah, making sure that this is never another outcome for Grambling State University, as UAPB has seemed to just be a little bit too much for them. Has had an 18-point deficit by Grambling State University with 2 minutes and 15 seconds left to go.
Man. These are the kind of games you hate to be a part of, you hate to have as a team, but you rather have it now when we got time to still fix it?
Oh, man, it's a lot of – most definitely. And then knowing that you're going to be a team that's going to definitely make a playoff push, this would just drop them down to 5-2 and improve UAPB to 4-3. They're definitely going to make a playoff push. This is a game that you remember. And women's basketball and men's basketball both are going to have UAPB marked off when the playoffs come around, because these are two teams that may very well meet paths when it comes to it. Four games only leave remaining after these two. I mean, after this one, as Zahad Mumford gets his first three-pointer to drop.
Put the lead down to
17. Trying to get away from that lucky number 20 for them. 24 points for Milton. 23 points for Joe French. Flett has 14. Martin Jr. has 23.
5-23. This is going to drive with the tough bucket over for you. Back to 19 points. Milton scoring his 22nd, his 26th point of the game. Minute 30 left in the game. 84-65. Free throw is no good for Milton as we push it up on the right wing. Blocking foul called on Martin Jr. Blocking foul called on Martin to send Colton to the line and hopefully bring the lead down to 17 points. Really is just an unfortunate scenario and situation for Grambling State to be in right now, but like we did mention earlier, this is the time for, this is a good time for it just to happen for us as a team. Give you a time to be able to really learn your identity and see who we are at this point. Really just to show who you are at this point. Really just go. And it appears to be a slippery court now. Rep after step in too. And enjoy your bag a little bit. Clean up the rare cheering in the crowd from the Rams fans. About this game. Haven't had too much of that this game, but it is good to see we are still in some high spirits throughout the court, throughout the arena. As the first free throw was good, cut the lead down to 18. 66 points for Grambling State Tigers. As the second free throw goes up, and it is good. To cut the lead down to 17, 84-67, UAPB, minute 25 left. With Williams is inbounding it to Milton as Dozier is full court pressure. Looking at the top of the key, really up the right corner.
Martin, pump face, and there will be another whistle. With 56 seconds left in this one. Double bonuses on both sides. We're gonna see Zach Reinhardt checking the game. They're gonna sound like the crowd is excited about him.
Man, sound like a fan favorite, apparently.
Sound like a fan favorite. Never heard. It should have been as Zach come out, I guess.
Man.
Zach and Ware. Oh, they put another one. Name McCauley. Caleb Stokes is gonna take him as well.
Seems like Zach was the missing key piece for the UAPB tonight. Really needed Zach tonight. He's a game changer.
Now, I don't know how much this game can change. 56 seconds left and 18
deficit. Hey, sound like the crowd knows something we don't know about Zach Bond.
I may question if the crowd knows it. Goodness gracious.
Yeah. While you were gone, we seen the crowd cheering for the ref wiping the floor, so I can agree with that sentiment.
That's true. Michael Bowden at the top. Kicks it out, though, here. Three-pointer. Oh, it's nothing. Jordan Smith gets a shot up. No good.
Was that good?
That would be Aim McCauley.
Aim McCauley for the rebound. Immediate impact player gets in the game, immediately gets the board, just changing the tempo.
Hey, you know, in pain, you must laugh.
Hey, you can't laugh at your pain, what can you do with it?
As this one slowly winds down, UAPB was just too much for Grambling State University to handle. When it came to threes and everything, we're able to knock it down to Michael. Gonna get him another bucket. He's gonna finish this game off with 26 points.
Hey, good take over time.
We're gonna take a quick break here. We're not actually gonna stay here. There's no timeout. 5 seconds left. Next stop we'll have will be the conclusion of the game. Grambling State University now falls to 9-11. 5-6. Like UAPB advances to 8-12. Grambling State University will be 5-6. And UAPB will now be 9-11 and 4-3 in the SWAC. We'll have Coach Dante Jackson coming over, and then we will get an interview from Jermichael Molden. Riley McClain, our sideline reporter, will be giving us that. We'll be right back here on Grambling State University Sports Television Network.
HBCUs are anchored by legacy. They nurture the talent and determination of their students and prepare them for a bright future. The Home Depot's Retool Your School program has and still believes in the excellence of HBCUs, committed not just in speech, but through the revitalization and upgrades of the campuses these students call home. Building, planting, tilling the dream, all hearts and countless volunteers on the ground. Retool Your School. We're powered by purpose.
This is it. Our last night sharing a room. Tomorrow, we'll be in our new home.
They told you buying a home would take years, but didn't help you start. Still, you kept trying.
You'll have a yard to play in, a place to dream.
Hope makes it happen. With tailored mortgage solutions, Hope Credit Union makes homeownership happen for thousands of people, regardless of income or credit. Brighter futures begin with Hope.
Going. This game's not over. So we're not the best.
Our kicker stubbed his toe on the ball, and pretty sure our mascot has this costume on backwards.
But this is our team. No matter what.
Reinvention, take your business. Accenture, let there be change.
Hello and welcome back to the Grambling State University Sports Television Network. I'm Monaji Morris. Of course, I am here with Coach Dante Jackson. It was a tough one tonight. They were able to rain threes in an efficient rate. Can you kind of walk us through what happened and some of the adjustments you try to make during the game?
Listen, when you don't guard the ball screen well, man, you give up tee up threes, and unfortunately, that's what it is. We gave up 14 threes tonight. 14 threes go for what, 42 points, if I'm not mistaken, if my math is right. They don't win too many games where you know you give them 14 three-pointers.
Oh, yeah, most definitely. And Joe French had a lot of those. But on our end, Of course, Jermichael Moten had him a great game, 26 points. Hopefully that carries over into next week. Can you kind of talk about his play?
Well, you know, Jermichael played really well, you know, but he's one of these guys that's been around for the games of this magnitude. And when I told our guys, this is one of these championship-type games. They're coming in. They got good players. We got good players. They have to be ready to play. And unfortunately, like I told them, if you don't come ready to play, you know, you get beat. And that's one of our situations. We didn't have all our guys ready to play. We didn't hit shots, and they dared us to make shots, and we didn't.
Now, looking forward to next week, next game, big game, TNT. It's going to be the Legacy Bowl Classic. You're going to face off against Jackson State, a team that would face in the playoffs and knocked out of the playoffs. What is something to look forward to? They have been on fire, looking like a lot of the same guys on that team, catching wind, catching fire, pretty good team. What is the game plan?
Well, you know, right now, you know, we got to deal with this and dissect this, and then we'll get to Jackson. You know, right now we'll focus on them once I get through breaking down this film and trying to correct the mistakes from tonight. So I can't look that far forward. I got to correct these mistakes.
Yes, Coach. All right, Coach. Thank you. Every time, looking forward to the next win.
Thank you, young fella.
All right, Coach. Thank you guys for watching and tuning in to the GSU TV. Of course, next time we'll have a game. It won't be us. It will be on TNT, the Legacy Bowl against Jackson State. Big game. Make sure you guys tune in. Thank you for watching. Thank you for everybody that participated. Thank you to the crew. Thank you to the commentators, sideline reporters. And thank you most of all for watching. Peace and love and unity. Bye.